Hello and welcome back to hopefully a few Rated Arena games here. I have quite a few games that I would like to cast. I don't really have time. Let's see how this game is going. It's between Dracont playing in yellow as the Mayans and FedEx playing in red, also Mayans. We know FedEx to be a very experienced arena player. He's been very strong in the Master Arena 2 tournament, as far as I remember. Not sure about the first one. Maybe you can catch me up on that. I don't know why Dracont is using Village Number 5 on the next sheep. Doesn't make sense to me. Maybe there was a misclick, I don't know. And Dracont, of course, pretty well known among the community with his battle against Metal RTS. Though we have seen quite a few funny and really interesting games between those two players. The secret final of Master Arena 4 happening quite early between Metal and Dracont. Let's see how this game is going. I have no idea how much FedEx has been playing. I think Dracont has been playing quite a bit and he's become pretty decent. He's established on like a 2K rating, 1948 here, between 1900 and 2K on, I guess, Arabia as well as Arena, which is nice to see. And for now, an Arena game. Let's go for the maps. Actually, let's see the players pretty close towards one another, but I don't think we see any boar steals. Let me actually quickly check. There's one boar in the back, two boars in the back for Dracont. And FedEx, one boar inside, and the second boar, there's three deer inside for him. Let's actually go for his map. The second boar also inside, so no boar steals incoming. Not a very nice wood line here for FedEx. That's the closest one. That's not really a nice one. And we do see the first boar coming in for FedEx here. It's got a main stone forward and a second stone also for, but inside at least. The third gold is outside. The main gold very safe in the back, and the second gold also safe in the back for him, which is nice. He's gonna collect those two sheep. He's got three deer inside, which is always nice to have. So the stone may be the only, let's call it, problem. It's not really a problem. Nice park in the boar under the TC, perfect for FedEx. And I think he's gonna go for a quite early castle usually, so he shouldn't have problems to actually protect the stone here. And we have to have any relics around here for FedEx? Not really. We have this gold, which is actually belongs to Dracon. Let's go for his base. We saw the two boars inside. Also three deer inside, even close to the berries here, which is nice to have. Can choose where to lure those boars. And by population 14, Dracont hasn't started to lure the first boar. Only now, 15 population, he's getting the first boar and he's going to take another sheep, which again, not a good timing here, I don't know. Maybe the star was messed up a little bit. It usually doesn't really matter, but it's not that clean, and you usually want to have a, let's call it, clean start. Makes playing easier. This boar should not be able to run back. Yeah, Dracont is getting it back to TC, but it's not staying. You can't park it, as FedEx was doing before. Another villager has to start shooting, and now it's parked, which is good for FedEx, for Dracont. He can now take the boar easily. He's gonna start to lure those deer in. He's also got the main gold very safe in the back, which is nice for him. He has a lot of nothing in here, apparently. We saw the third gold being outside, almost as close to FedEx as it is to Dracont. The main stone really forward towards FedEx base. This could be exploited. A second gold also outside, and a second stone outside. Not a really good map. On the other hand, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 relics, all in almost one screen. I think I can just not fit them in, but they're really close to Dracon space, so he may be able to get that relic advantage. It should be nice for him. I think I can go a little bit faster. It's going relatively slow right now. I'm not sure why. I hope I'm using the right setting. But I'm gonna go with this right now. And no extra resources as far as I can see, which is surprising to me. Of course it happens, but usually you do see some extra. Right here we have a lot of nothing, only wood and plain land. So let's see how players are doing this. And I think I can go faster once again. 100 speed, and it's really not going too fast. Of course the Reckon is gonna lure the rest of his deer towards the TC, or rather the mill here. And FedEx lured the three deer in towards the TC at a very short luring distance, which is awesome. One villager standing in the middle of nothing, not sure what it's doing there. And we have FedEx clicking up to Feudal Age. You see the research bar here right now. Not sure how long a villager was idle, I guess not for too long. So FedEx clicking up first, going two villages on gold and not on stone, which is interesting to see. As for Dracont, is he on going on stone? He's not clicked up yet. He's got one villager on gold right now. He's sending three to stone, four to stone even. Maybe he's gonna sell 100 stone. It makes sense to have only one villager because usually you want to get your three villages in. On the other hand, Dracont did not do a loom at the start, which is really interesting for me. I don't think it's the best thing to do, but some players tend to skip loom at the start to get that extra time and to save it for later. I've also saved 50 gold, which is nice to have. I still think that Drakhan needs a second villager on gold. It's a little bit of a mistake in my opinion. And finishing the third tier, and I guess is gonna fix this. Or maybe having four villagers on stone is actually gonna sell some stone. Would make sense too. And again, I should go faster. And let's see, can I get a sweep spot here? 82 seems okay for now. I don't know, I want to cast one, I don't have that much time. If I want to get a second game in, I may also go a little bit faster than I did along this game right now. Market Blacksmith coming up for FedEx, nothing surprising here. Only surprise, no stone being taken by FedEx. FedEx clicking up to Castle Age, Drakhan is up to Feudal, Market Blacksmith also coming up for him. Kind of preparing a little building wall of here and clicking up the castle age, having five villagers on gold and on stone, and now two on gold. So I'm assuming he did not have to sell. No, he should have enough gold. Should have had enough gold. Let me check the prices here. Actually, 169.91 stone price. That's standard to see. I'm guessing FedEx is going to go to TCs, maybe Monastery very quick. Monastery coming up. No, Barracks coming up. Sorry, it's not up to Castle Age. Barracks is a really interesting option here. Monastery also, and one TC being dropped on the main gold. No, on the wood line. One villager being attacked, but FedEx has Loom, so no problem for him. Drakhan housed, the start of Castle Age, 30 population, and he's missing 100 stone. No, he's building two TCs immediately, one on the main gold, one on the wood line here. Sadly, only 5 tiles between the TCs, not 6, cannot fit all the farms there. And Eagle Warrior production starting for FedEx, but he's losing a monk here, and that's something that should not have happened. Drakhan at the same time has the 700 stone, 650 required, so 50 even left. Getting a castle up, and FedEx may be able to grab a lot of relics here if he's fast enough. But at the same time, the castle and plumed archers coming out means Drakhan may be able to go aggressive in mid-castle age while having 3 TCs, and this is really awesome for him. FedEx getting another TC on the wood line here, so 3 TCs also up for him. Did not go on stone, his resource is a little bit higher right now than Drakhan's, which makes sense. And Drakhan now getting a lot of farms as well. The castle is up, so he's safe for now. First plumed archers on the way. And FedEx is gonna try and get a lot of relics in here really quickly. That's 1, 2, 3, number 4 coming in, and that's only one remaining here. And I don't think that Drakhan is gonna go for it. I think FedEx is gonna get the last relic as well, even doing Sanctity just in case. Now the boom has begun, and I don't think we're gonna see any really fast Imperial Ages. I don't think we're gonna see a lot of Plumed Archer against Eagle Warrior action. And FedEx actually investing a little bit of gold and food as well as 175 wood to make sure to get a lot of relics in. He's skipping the last one. Maybe does not want to lose the monks here. Wheelbarrow coming in for FedEx right now. Villager-wise, Drakhan is ahead by 9 right now, like by roughly 8-9 villagers, which is very strong for him. Stone mining and gold mining coming in around 23-24 minutes. And a lot of farms coming. We are playing Farming Simulator right now. A few plumed archers now on the field, taking down the remaining Eagle Warriors. Drakhan also doing Loom. This is not really interesting. Of course, you can go into detail here. This monk should not go down. All the plumed archers are there, and the Eagle Warrior saying bye bye. FedEx with a big mistake. It might be in Boso coming in after 24 minutes. You should get that like at 16. And missing Boso is a big problem because it's such a strong economy bonus, such a strong upgrade. On the other hand, FedEx with a lot of resources in the bank and clicking up to Imperial Age right now, going for stone. I really don't like this mining camp. Should have one tile in between it because you usually want to fit like more than 4 villages here. And what buildings do we have for FedEx? We still see Monastery versus the University for him. My University, Siege Workshop is up, didn't see that. Makes sense. Imperial Age also for Drakhan, Padded Archer Armor. Of course, he's got the castle already. And enough stone for a second castle right now, so he's gonna go into Elite Plumed Archers if he's allowed to. Or Elite Plumes, probably a few traps at the start of Imperial Age. He got the last relic in. To have at least one handcart coming in for both players. Fletching on the way for Drakhan as well. And villager-wise, 87 against 81. The big difference, but Drakhan 100 from 200 score lead. Makes sense. Manganel is on the field inside the space, inside FedEx space 2 actually. To make sure that the approaching eagle, approaching plumed archers may need to go away for some time. Now there's 7 villagers on stone. Again, this should have been one more tile to the left, to the top left. And apparently FedEx going mini boom into Eagle Warriors, and he's got a lot of gold in the bank. He's missing a little bit of food, creating Eagle Warriors. Is he getting the Elite Eagle upgrade? He's got a barracks here. No, creating. Yep, there it is. Elite Eagle Warrior. Do we see plus two defense? Can he afford plus four? Almost. Heavy plow conscription, two men sword bracer coming in for Drakkhand. Gotta see plumed archers against eagles, or to be more precise, elite eagle warriors against what is most likely gonna be elite plumed archers and being clicked in a few seconds. Conscription finishing, and I think 1k wood, 500 food, is that it? Blade mail armor from FedEx, chemistry, two moons of thumb ring. Would have preferred to see elite plumed archers, to be honest. Does Drakkhand know about the. Okay, he saw the Eagle Warriors, but I don't think he knows about the Elite Eagle upgrade for FedEx. This might be a surprise here for Drakkhand, actually. There's a lot of potential in here, but only now plate mail armor coming in, and you need at least two attack upgrades. Without a plus two, at least, possibly plus four, the plumed archer is still too strong. And the plumed archer is five plus four incoming with the chemistry upgrade. And of course, the 4+3 range. So they are fully upgraded attack wise. Don't know if they get, I guess they don't have. No, we saw thumb ring, sorry. Ballistics must be none, and now we have Elite Eagle Warriors plus one attack against Elite Plumed Archers. Done, I didn't see it, but it was researched, it makes sense. Drakkhand had a lot of resources here, and we're gonna see the first fights go a little bit slower. Elite Eagle Warriors going back and forth, as well as the Elite Plumed Archers, and Eldorado on the way, as well as Iron Casting here. For FedEx, Eldorado, very important upgrade to give those Elite Eagles the 100 HP. And Elite Plumed Archers getting a few good shots, and now I have to take a pause. Phew, where was I? That was a big break for me. Not for you, of course. Let's continue in the middle of a fight. A few ramps coming in. Trebuchet is shooting at this castle, which I didn't really point out. I think three castles actually up. And let me get... this decent speed and start the game again. Manganel hitting the ramps, but the ramps are gonna approach those trebuchets, take at least one of them down, I guess. Now there's Eagle Warriors, at the same time Elite Eagle Warriors killing Elite Plumed Archers here. Eldorado is done, 100 HP Eagles, so the Plumed Archers have to go back. This castle went down, and of course Drakkhand is creating a lot of Plumed Archers right now. He's getting another castle up. The three trebuchets are remaining, the ramps are down, the mangonels are down actually, and now I think this is a bad fight for FedEx. He should go back, because under the castle, the Elite Eagle Warriors are not strong enough at this point, there's not enough numbers, and the Plumed Archers are in a decent spot to hit a lot of Elite Eagle Warriors. Of course, FedEx can reinforce really fast. Drakkhand gold pretty low, FedEx all pretty low actually. Ring Archer Hammer coming in for Drakkhand as well, so the Plumed Archers will be fully upgraded. Blast Furnace also incoming for the Eagle Warriors, same thing here, and Drakkhand saying well played and resigns. FedEx winning this game using the Elite Eagle Warriors under the cast. He's getting out of them. Very nice strategy here. A little bit of a mini boom. FedEx made sure to get the relics, four of them, which you want to have if you go with like 5-10 barracks, I guess, 11 barracks. So Elite Eagle Warriors very, very expensive when it comes to gold in the long run. But FedEx has a very nice strategy here, and he even had more villages in the end. 43 military ones against Drakkhand had only one plumed archer, didn't get enough plumed archers out fast enough, and like this 35 minutes games and my game and FedEx winning this one. I hope you enjoyed this, and there's a few more between them, I think. So see you in the next game. GG.